Hello students, welcome to Auja Classes Smartness in Education. Today we are going to learn about the basics of lines and angles. Let us first talk about a line. A line is basically a geometrical entity which can be extended forever in both the directions as shown in figure. This is the representation of a line in which two points A and B have been assumed and it can be extended in both the directions infinitely. Next is the line segment. A line segment is just a part of a line. It has two endpoints like this. This is the line segment. It can be represented as A, B, and geometrically we can write it as AB bar. And on the line, we can represent it like this. Next is a ray. A ray starts at one point and continues on forever in one direction like this. See, this is the starting point of the ray and it is going forward in this rightward direction. Let us suppose this point is being A and this point is being B. And a ray can be represented as AB arrow. Now, let us talk about parallel lines and intersecting lines. What are the parallel lines? Parallel lines are the lines in the same plane that if they are extended to infinity, they would never intersect or they would never cross each other at a particular point. See, these are two lines L1 and L2. These are going in the same direction and they can never intersect or meet each other. Next is the intersecting lines. Intersecting lines are the lines in the same plane that can cross each other at a particular point. See, these are two lines. Suppose this is L1 and this is L2 and they are crossing each other at suppose point P. Now, let us talk about some basic terminology of angles. What is an angle? An angle is basically the union of two non-collinear rays. Collinear rays means there are two rays which are not on each other. These are different rays which intersect at a particular point or with a common initial point. So an angle is the union of two collinear rays which start from a common initial point. See, OA and OB are the rays and this is the representation of angle AOB. Now, let us talk about the interior of an angle. The interior of an angle is the set of all points in its plane which lie on the same side of both the rays. This is the internal portion of the angle AOB. So this is known as interior of angle AOB. Now, what is the exterior of an angle? The exterior of an angle is the set of all the points lying in its plane and which are outside of both the rays. All the points outside of these rays is known as exterior of angle AOB. Next, let us talk about congruent angles. The angles which are equal in magnitude or equal in measurement are known as congruent angles. That means two angles are said to be congruent if the trace copy of one can be superimposed to the other and it can cover and they can cover each other completely and exactly. See here, there are two angles and their measure is equal to 50 degrees. So these two angles can overlap each other exactly and completely. So we can say that these two angles are congruent. Suppose this angle is AOB. This is suppose PQR. So angle AOB is equals to angle PQR. And we can also say that angle AOB is congruent to angle PQR. Now, let us talk about different types of angles. First is the acute angle. Any angle that is less than 90 degrees measure is known as acute angle. This angle is 46 degrees, so it is an acute angle. Next is the right angle. An angle that is exactly of 90 degrees is known as right angle. Next is obtuse angle. An angle that is greater than 90 degrees but less than 180 degrees is known as obtuse angle. The condition is that the angle must be greater than 90 but less than 180 degrees. Now, the straight angle is basically an angle that is always equal to 180 degrees. This is the straight angle. Now, reflex angle. What is a reflex angle? An angle that is greater than 180 degrees but less than 360 degrees is called reflex angle. Greater than 180 but less than 360 degrees is known as reflex angle. And next is the full angle or complete angle that is exactly equal to a measurement of a circle. That means a measurement of circle in angular form, and that is equal to always 360 degrees. Now, let us talk about complementary angles. Complementary means which complete each other. Here, the meaning of completion is that the two angles whose sum is equal to 90 degrees are called complementary angles, means which complete the angle of 90 degrees. Let us see for an example. In this 90 degrees angle, there is one more ray which forms angle A and angle B, and the measurement of angle A and angle B in summation form is equals to 90 degrees. See, there are two angles. First is 40 degrees, second is 50 degrees. These two angles are complementary because their sum will give equal to the angle of 90 degrees. So 40 degrees and 50 degrees are complementary angles. Similarly, angle of 30 degrees and 60 degrees are also complementary angles. Similarly, we can form many complementary angles by making their sum as equal to 90 degrees. Next is supplementary angles, means the angles whose measure is equal to 180 degrees are called supplementary angles. Here, the sum is equal to 180 degrees. So let us see, for example, we have two angles. First is 130 degrees and second is 50 degrees, and their sum is always equal to 180 degrees. So we can say that angle ABC and angle PQR are supplementary angles. These are supplementary angles. Now, this is the summarized form of complementary and supplementary angles. Complementary angles add up to 90 degrees. Here, example is shown as 30 degrees, 38 degrees and 52 degrees, whose sum will give us equal to 90 degrees. The angles whose sum is 90 degrees are known as complementary angles. Similarly, supplementary angles which add up to 180 degrees. That means the angles whose sum is equal to 180 degrees are called supplementary angles. Here, angle of 128 and 52 degrees are measuring equal to 180 degrees. Now, let us talk about adjacent angles. See here, two angles are said to be adjacent angles if any two angles are said to be adjacent if they have the same vertex. If their vertex point is same, that means see here, angle AOB and angle BOC are connected with each other at point O, and these are both adjacent angles because they are joined by a common ray. They have the same vertex and they have a common arm like OB. And uncommon arms are either side of the common arm. Means other two arms are on different sides of the ray OB or the common arm OB. That means OC and OA are on the different sides of this common arm OB. Now, linear pair of angles. This is a particular form of angles in which two adjacent angles are said to form a linear pair when their non-common arms are two opposite rays. See here, this is the linear pair of angles in which this is the adjacent angles, angle 1 and angle 2 are adjacent, and they are such that the other two rays except common ray are on the opposite directions. That means OA and OC are just opposite to each other. That means OA and OC are opposite rays. So this complete angle is equal to always 180 degrees, and this is known as linear pair because it is forming a line. So it is called linear pair of angles. That means angle 1 plus angle 2 is equals to 180 degrees. So it is forming a straight line or straight angle. Therefore, it is known as linear pair of angles. Angle 1 and angle 2 form linear pair of angles. Now, vertically opposite angles. Two angles are called a pair of vertically opposite angles if their arms form two pair of opposite rays like this. See here, we have two lines PQ and RS in which angle MN are just opposite to each other and angle AB are just opposite to each other. Here M is equals to N, A is equals to B. So two angles are called a pair of vertically opposite angles if their arms form two pairs of opposite rays. If their arms are forming two opposite rays, see here, RS and PQ are intersecting each other at this point. Suppose this point is being O, and they are forming two pair of opposite rays. This is one pair, means ROQ and POS. Similarly, SOQ and POR. Thank you. In the next lectures, we will learn about some theorems and axioms related to lines and angles. Thank you.